Jay Schreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies. Me and James are out here at the Superstations walking around, and we're looking at some places that we think may be potential spots where there might be a cache of gold, which would be really nice, right? That'd be awesome. And we were talking about probably the top five things that would have to prepare you to come out here and hike the and search for the lost Dutchman gold. And I would say the number one thing that you would need to know about the Superstitions was to do the history. What do you think, James?
Yeah, it's all about research.
So what do you think the percentage of the research would be versus the actual going and doing?
Ooh, I'd say at least 50% of your efforts need to be put into research so you know where you're going and what you're getting yourself into before you get out here.
So, you know, the first thing is, and you know, the nice thing about research today is that, you know, there's so much availability on the web today, right, that you didn't used to have. And you can actually do a lot of your research and planning, you know, on the internet. You know, another thing that's really nice now is that you can Google a lot of this stuff, you know, Google Maps. You can get into a lot of these different places and kind of get an idea of what you want to do and how you want to do it. And so I would say if you're really serious about, and maybe not even so serious, but you'd like to get an adventure going, right? A lot of what we do is just adventure stuff, right? Who doesn't want to be Indiana Jones, right? I mean, who doesn't want to think they're going to find the Temple of Doom, you know? So you do your research. And I would say the second most important thing if you're going to search the Lost Dutchman would be your physical preparation. Does that make sense?
Absolutely.
I mean, everything you're going to do out here is going to be involved in some type of physical work. I mean, I don't care what you do, and I don't care how you do it, but you're going to be walking somewhere. And if you're not physically prepared to be able to come out here and put the miles in it's going to take, because what a lot of people don't realize is they think the Superstition is just that one ridge mount of mountains, and the reality of it is that, you know, that's just a small portion of the 166,000 acres. I said 1,000 acres. You know, it goes 40 to 50 miles one way, right? So you've got a lot of ground to cover, and so you better be physically prepared to be able to do that. And then, you know, I'd say, James, the most important, the third thing I think is logistics, right? Mm-hmm. How are you going to get out here? I mean, so you physically got yourself ready, you've planned. So now what? Now what you got to do is, how am I going to get out here? And when I get out here, where am I going to stay? And when I get out here, you know, how am I going to get to the trailheads? How am I going to do, what am I going to do to be able to make sure that once I even get out here, where am I going to be? A lot of people don't realize that, you know, if you're in downtown Phoenix, and let's just say, for example, you booked a room at Goodyear. Well, you could be 70, 80 miles from the Superstitions easily. So you're going to spend an hour to an hour and a half, 2 hours maybe, getting here one way. So, you know, logistics are critical of kind of knowing where you want to stay and how you want to do what you want to do. So let's say you pick the right hotel. Let's say you're in Apache Junction. You're close to the trail, okay? Let's say you've done the physical work. But then which trailhead are you going to go to? You know, there's dozens and dozens of trailheads that go all the way around this location. And depending on where you're going to hike, and then how far in are you going to hike? You're going to stay all night somewhere? Are you going to camp out? You know, what are you going to do? So that's the second thing you got to be able to do is figure out, okay, what's my plan? So logistically, where am I going to stay? Where am I going to search? And then I would say the next thing, you know, James, I don't know about you, but your equipment. I mean, you know, the gear that you've got, right? What's some suggestions that you would suggest as far as equipment?
Oh, well, I mean, you're absolutely going to want to have some form of GPS, whether it's your smartphone, or actual, you know, like the Garmins or any of those types of devices. But you're also going to want to have just a compass and a map of some sort, because you need to have backup for all of this. There is absolutely no cell service in most of the areas you're going to find yourself.
Now, water-wise, is there water out in the soups? I mean, you
do not want to rely on the natural water sources in areas like this. So you're going to want to carry as much water as you possibly can. I always carry a water filter in case I do stumble upon some natural creeks. But you know, a good hydration bladder and a couple extra bottles that you can source if you do stumble upon a pool or a creek or anything like that are absolutely essential out here.
You know,
like you said, it changes so much, you don't know what you're going to end up in.
You know, that's the difficult thing too, is that if you're not used to hauling stuff out of here, you know, you got to haul your equipment in, you got to be backpacking in, and then how long you're going to stay. So you need to understand how long you are going to stay out here if you're going to do this, and what it's going to take to get out here. And I would say the last thing, and again, you don't get cell service out here, do you?
Not at all.
So you're not going to be able to call the, what they call the $40,000 ride out of the Superstitions, right? And that is when they helicopter you out. Your minimum's $20,000 up to $40,000, right? So that's what's going to cost you to get hauled out of here. And then last, I'd say an emergency plan, right?
Yep.
What do I do if I get in trouble? What if I'm 25 miles out and my truck doesn't start? You know, have a plan for everything you possibly believe that could go wrong, because trust me, in the Superstition Mountains, if you think it'll go wrong, it will. Everything that could possibly go wrong out here does go wrong. So I think that is the top five things I would suggest if you want to search the Lost Dutchman Mine or the Lost Dutchman Gold. Those would be the top five things I think you need to know. Does that sound like a good plan, James?
I think that's exactly what you need if you're going to start this adventure.
So, you know, if you've got any comments, please leave them down below. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, because we're gonna do the research with you, and then we'll go out and find it. So if you can't get out here to Arizona, well, guess what? You don't need to. We'll take care of that for you. Jay Schreck and James on the trail of the Lost Dutchman's Gold.